Hello everyone, and welcome to the Great Outdoors RV Company. My name is Will.
My name is Mate, and today we are checking out the WILDWOOD X-Lite 201BHXL. This is a bunkhouse, awesome unit, you'll love it. WILDWOOD is doing some awesome things this year, compared to last year, to top it all off.
Yeah, there's a lot of extra little bonus features, like this remote right here, for example. This allows me, if I want to, change the colors on the LED strip. I can do that.
Oh, nice.
Cycle through the colors if I want. Mate has an even more functional remote, though.
I like this one a little bit better, because if I want to make this awning go out, I'm just pushing a button to pull that off. If I want to be able to put the stab jacks down, I can push a button to do that. Let's see if I can select the back stab jacks, and I can put those up and down. Those are going up now. You can also control lights, so if I wanted to be able to turn lights on and off, you can do that with this guy as well.
Mm-hmm. And they also now are coming prepped for backup cameras on the WILDWOOD, so if you want to option in a backup camera, the wiring's there, ready to go. You just got to plug it in. So there's a lot more to show you on this unit on the outside and inside, so let's get started.
To start off on the back side here, you can either control the power stabilizer jacks by remote by coming over here and pushing a button manually, or you can manually crank them up and down as well. You have your low point drains right here. You also have your beautiful power awning. This guy can also bend down on this side, so if you wanted to be able to shoot the water over this way, you can do that. You also have outside speakers, two of them, and the beautiful lights above, and you'll notice that they have some cool lights running down here too. That just makes it nice running down the road, as well as at nighttime it actually will light up this area. Mm-hmm. And you know what's impressive about these LED lights? We were actually camping out this weekend. Right. It actually shoots out all the way well beyond the awning even, and it's pretty bright.
It gets really, really bright, and it's not like glaring in your eyes like a big, gigantic floodlight would be. So I think it's a lot nicer when you're camping outside. So right here, you also happen to have some plugins. So if you guys want to plug in a 110 outlet into there, you can. You also have the radius door, and you also have a screen door too. If you want to leave that open and get some extra ventilation and light, you can. Now over here, you can also adjust this. You can pitch this down low if you want to, just like Mate did previously on the coach. And then here is some access to storage underneath. So pass-through storage down there. You also have your control for your electric jacks here. And then the solar plug. Now this is coming standard on all WILDWOODs as well. So if you want to charge your batteries with the solar panel, all you got to do is set a panel out in the sun, plug it into this, and the wires feed directly to your battery.
Over here on the front, you'll notice this is a smooth type of material instead of a corrugated, so that's a little bit nicer because it's thicker metal. It's 40 mil aluminum. You have two 20 pound propane bottles. You have a power tongue jack with a manual override if you need to. You just pull this guy off and you can be able to manually override that.
You have a small light on the front to help you connect and disconnect at nighttime. The bottles on the propane are automatically crossing over, so if one runs dry, it'll flip over to the next. And then you got this diamond shield right here. So this is, of course, where rock strikes are most likely to happen.
And this is higher than a lot of the competition, I've noticed.
It is, which is important. I mean, you don't want to have this getting all scuffed up and beat up by rocks as you drive down the road. Mm-hmm. Now this coach, it's a pretty lightweight coach. It's
4162.
Man, that's going to be towed by all of your half tons very easily. A lot of SUVs can haul that as well.
Well, and the nice thing about that is this is about the smallest you get and still have a tandem axle, mm-hmm. which is going to pull better down the road. It's not going to fishtail nearly as much.
Yeah, single axles tend to be a little more squirrely, so this is going to be a lot more stable as you're driving down. Now, over here, you have a GVWR of 7528. This thing can hold a ridiculous amount of cargo. Chances are you'll never even get up to the full GVWR of this coach. You're going to be sticking probably closer to that 6,000 pound range
and that's because this, you could have either done this as a single axle or a double axle because it's right there on that borderline, but by going to that double axle, it gave you a lot more capacity.
Yeah. Now right here is the other door to that pass-through storage we talked about earlier. Again, you can see all the way through to the passenger side of the vehicle. There's a lot of windows on this unit for only being about 21 foot. You have this large emergency window exit right here. You can also just prop this open and get some ventilation. You can even leave it open in the rain because it kind of pops open like this, so rain's not gonna shoot in that way. Over here is your furnace exhaust. That's what this little thing is. We get questions on that sometimes. Kitchen window. There's your city water connection. So if you're hooked up to like pressurized water, you can hook your hose directly to that and you'll have on-demand water. Now, if you're camping away from water connections, that's where you'll fill up this. This fills up your water tank. So you'd put your hose in here and then fill that up. There's even a little attachment you can buy in our parts store if you want that fills it up really quickly. And that, of course, you flip on your water pump and you have pressurized water camping away from all hookups. Down here, you can see the tandem axle setup. They're nitrogen-filled tires as well. So the nitro is designed to try to expand and contract less with temperature changes, so it's designed to try to extend the life of your tires as well. And then directly up above here, this is your 30 amp connection. So this right over here will plug into a regular 30 amp power source. Now, if you didn't have a 30 amp connection nearby, we include a little adapter that fits onto this, and that'll allow you to plug into a regular 110 outlet.
Over here, you have your water heater. This can run off of gas, and it's a DSI hot water heater. So that means it can be able to turn on that hot water heater without lighting a pilot light out here. You just have to push a button on the inside. And then this is where your dump connections are. This is your gray and black tank, and they do have the 12 volt heat pads. So if you do want to go a little bit longer in the season where it's a little bit colder, they're rated down to negative 11 degrees. Right above that is your storage. You can access this storage over, this is the bunk bed area. So this is below the bunk areas. And then the top bunk also has a window above there. As we move on to the backside, you'll notice there is the plug-in port if you want to add a backup camera. And then this roof is a one-piece rubber roof that has a 12-year warranty on it. 1 year bumper-to-bumper, and a lot of the appliances even have a second year.
You know something else I really like about the Wildwoods? It's simple, but that little spout right there, that's a just a little downspout. So when you have water running off, these have curved roofs on the top to help shed that water. It's not gonna leave gigantic black street marks from all the dust and stuff that gets on the roof.
You know? A lot of guys, those downspouts are about half that length. And what happens is that water catches
all
right
down here.
And then that can cause problems where it starts to rot out that wood right behind there.
Now over here, on the bumper, I wanted to show you this. You can pull out this piece of rubber right here, and this will store nicely the little sewer hose that we give you when you come to pick up a coach from us. And then that's really close to your dump station too. Now, this will fit the hose we give you, but if you end up buying an upgraded sewer hose, something really nice that's, you know, can be crushed and all that stuff and spring right back, it probably won't fit this, but you could always use that as a backup as well. Now, right over here, you have your cable and satellite connections as well. So, cable goes right here, satellite goes right here, and that'll of course pipe into the coach for you. Spare tire with a cover to keep that from getting chewed up by the sun. And then, well, I think you guys have seen most of the outside. Let's go inside, let's see Mate, and he'll start showing you some of the features in there.
Come on over this way, and we'll let you view the inside. So there she be. Those are the bunk beds, the air conditioning, the two-door refrigerator, the dinette, and I'm gonna throw this remote that I had outside right here on the wall. So they have a handy little location so that you don't lose it. And we wanna show you how this Murphy bed. So they do have the little armrests if you need them, which are kinda nice.
You can lift it up like that. You can see there's storage underneath there, so you can access that pass through and down here.
And this has a lock.
That's a new feature, yeah.
Yeah, a lot of the competition is not doing this, but this is kind of nice so that once you're in the down position, it locks. The other guys, if they don't have that, this thing can actually, it could be kind of bad. You could get like stuck back there.
Yeah.
But this one, you don't have to worry about that.
Right. You have wardrobe space on each side of the bed as well, and there's some storage up above too. And you notice it's not so close to the bed that it's a head knocker if you sat up in the middle of the night or something like that. There's LED lights throughout the entire coach. And then directly above me, there's a, what you call a king jack, what do I say? A TV antenna. So right here, I can rotate this, and that's actually rotating the TV antenna up on the roof of this coach. So this thing can receive HD channels wherever you're at, and you can rotate it to kind of get the best signal.
As you can see, it's very difficult to put the bed back in place. And then let's move on to the kitchen area here. I wanted to show you that you also have this table extension that just folds up and locks into place if you do need a little bit more extra counter space. Large basin sink, sometimes people call this a farm basin sink. High-rise sink faucet, so if you need to get your big pots and pans in here, you can do that, no problem. Large storage. You'll notice they've already cut this out for silverware, so it's pre-done for you. This is a remote for the stereo system, if you care. And then this is also a ball bearing glide drawers. So it makes it so that you can pull those all the way out. And then we haven't even covered all the...
Oh yeah, there's storage galore in this. I mean, storage over there, you have storage right here. It, that extends all the way back to the fridge.
And then we have, storage underneath both of the dinettes and the pantry storage here. More storage underneath here. Gosh. And then don't forget about using your oven. You can also use that as extra storage as well. And your microwave, of course. Mm-hmm. And then this guy folds back. It's a glass top, so if you needed to use extra counter space, you can do that. Three burner stove. Really has everything
it does
that you need.
You know, over here by the door, we forgot to mention this, there's your 12 volt radio system. So you can turn this on to get radio, it can play DVDs for you. There's even a USB connection, auxiliary port connection, SD card for whoever has SD cards anymore. But if you're camping and you have a really nice camera,
DSLR or something?
Yeah, you can stick that SD card in there and see that. And over here is your control panel. So here you can test to see how full your battery is, how full your fresh black tank, gray tank are. Turn on your water pump, turn on your water heater, turn on the lights inside the coach. We can turn them off like that. Some of them are controlled by the switch and some are controlled on their own. And then over here, you can also flip on your heated holding tank. So if you want to heat your fresh gray and black water, it's 12 volts, so it'll pull right off the battery. You just flip those switches there. Now directly above me is the AC for this unit. Now this thing is equipped with a 13.5 air conditioner, which in a coach this size is gonna turn this into an ice box if you wanted to. So here you can adjust the temperature, and then here you can also adjust the fan setting for it as well. You can just run it as a fan, or you can flip it over to here and turn on, of course, the cooling method as well. And then there's an optional heat pump in it too. And I think that this...
It does not have the heat pump built into it, but you can add that
into it if you want to. And you can open up these vents too to direct the air a little bit throughout the coach as well.
Mm-hmm. Now over here, you'll notice this has a spot. It's labeled TV backer. So if you do decide to add a TV, this is where all your connections are, and it's built very solid so that you can hang a bracket, maybe a swing arm so that you can view from everywhere in the coach. This also has a two-way built-in refrigerator. And you may be wondering what these little plastic things are. I wanted to show you that too. The way these work is they hook right here. When you put your refrigerator away for storage, you don't want to close the doors all the way because that can cause mold and mildew issues. These just lock just like that, and it leaves it open so the door's not flying back and forth as you're traveling down the road or leaving it in storage, I guess.
Now you obviously,
go ahead.
I was gonna say, you obviously have the bunk beds back here for sleeping. So two bunks, they have their own lights, and the top one has the nice egress window as well. But if you need more sleeping, you can fold your dinette here down into a bunk. So let's show you how you do that really quick. You just pop the table up. There's a couple of posts that obviously hold that up in place. And then there's a couple of supports underneath. Yeah, mate's putting it right on there now. And then you fill in with the cushions.
Oh, and then you have a 110 outlet right there.
You do. I was just noticing that too. So yeah, you got a nice 110 outlet. So if you need to charge some stuff or run a, I don't know, rent a PC, charge your phone, whatever the case is.
Sure.
And they also upgrade the blinds right here to the nice wooden shades, and I really like that.
And you'll notice this is a super large window.
Huge window.
Which is awesome when you're talking about, you know, this is where a lot of your mm-hmm. nice views are. That's a lot of times where your campsite is. So if you want to be able to see the kids playing outside while you're inside, mm-hmm. you can do that.
Yeah. Now this already has kind of a vinyl, you know, fabric here on the main side, the front side of this. But if you want to flip it over, like if you have really little kids and they kind of make a mess while they're eating, you can flip this over to this wipeable material over here too. And all the fronts and backs of all of these have that on them.
Coming back here to the bathroom area, you do have the tub, so if you have little guys, you can be able to bathe them a little bit easier. You also have the skylight, which a lot of guys leave out, which I think is important because it gives you not only some natural light, but also some headroom to work in here. Again, LED lights, these are gonna run at a much cooler pace because instead of running at about 200 degrees, these run at closer to 78 degrees. That way you're not fighting your AC, warming up the coach as you're camping outside. This also has a medicine cabinet instead of just the window here. You also have a sink in here. A lot of guys, they will only give you the kitchen sink and not give you a bathroom sink as well, which is can be kind of annoying. Extra storage here and then extra open storage here. The toilet paper holders are already pre-built in. Foot flush here. And then you can control the lights from up here, but you can also, if you have little people, you want to be able to control those on the wall as well so that they can reach the light and turn it on and off. One more thing that you need to test out when you're looking at coaches this side is the plate test, which is kind of silly, but it is actually a bigger problem in the RV industry than you would imagine. Can you actually fit two plates across from each other? Most campers, you cannot. That's also important if you're a board game fanatic. So if you want to be able to use that and have enough space, this table is actually larger than a lot of
competition. Yeah, you can play Ticket to Ride on this, actually.
Absolutely. Or Carcassonne.
Yeah. Puerto Rico?
Yes. Settlers of Catan?
Dominion?
Yep. The list goes on. Those are a list of awesome board games, by the way, that are great to play with your kids. Mm-hmm. So thanks for joining us, checking out the Wildwood X-Lite 201BHXL.
If you guys like this video, please hit that like button for us. That helps us out a lot. And also, if you'd like to see more of our content, hit that subscribe button and make sure you hit that bell next to it because we post pretty regularly on this channel. And if you have any questions, please drop us a line, leave us a comment.
And if this coach is a little too big, too heavy, because after all, this guy weighed how much?
It weighed a total of 4162.
And if you need to be closer to that 3,000 pound range, you need to check out the 196BH.
Or if you wanted something a little bit heavier, let's say, with a little more room, check out the 261BHXL or the 28D Bud.
Thanks, guys. Have a great day.